I'm J.R. Church. Welcome to today's webcast. It's Tuesday, March 30th, and I've got some emails here with questions from viewers that I'd like to address on today's broadcast. This one says, some years ago, maybe as long as 20 years, I heard a teaching on the phases of life, age-wise, for a Jewish man, what he goes through in accordance with Jewish customs, such as the age when he is considered to be an adult, a man of war, a man of peace, etc. I no longer remember the exact teaching. I vaguely remember the teaching paralleled the events of his life from his birth to the events of the state of Israel since its rebirth in 1948. If you're familiar with the teaching, would you be able to elaborate on it? Well, I am familiar with the teaching. We taught this back, I guess, 30 years ago. Let me just approach it now and bring you up to speed on it. First of all, when a Jewish boy is born, 8 days later, he enters the covenant called the Brit Milah, circumcision, the Jewish covenant. Now, when Israel first declared its independence and became a Jewish state, recognized immediately by the President of the United States, Harry Truman, they did not have an army. They did not have any ammunition. They had a few guns. Very little, no tanks, nothing with which to fight a war. Well, the Arab world immediately declared war on Israel and began to stage their tanks across Israel's border. And they were planning to invade Israel and push the Jews into the Mediterranean on the morning of the eighth day. That would be the day of circumcision for Israel. Well, the night before, the Jewish soldiers, ragtag army, commandeered all of the taxi cabs in Jerusalem and under the cover of darkness drove them out to the front lines back a mile or so from all of those Arab tanks sitting there. And the Arabs, of course, were sitting around enjoying the evening, you know, because they didn't expect an attack by the Jews. And they knew that with their tanks, they would be able to run over anything and push the Jews into the Mediterranean. They were feeling pretty good about it. But under the cover of darkness, the Jews took the manifolds off of the motors, eliminating the mufflers. And they also took out with them these oil drums and heavy chains. So some of the men pushed the oil drums while others rattled the chains across the oil drums, and then these motors sounded, without mufflers, sounded like tanks. And so they cranked them up on cue and started moving slowly toward those Arabs and their tanks. Well, needless to say, this spooked the Arabs and they fled. So the Jews just simply drove up to the tanks, got out of their taxi cabs, got in the tanks, and drove the tanks back into Israel. And suddenly Israel had tanks and guns and ammunition and all of the things that the Arabs left behind when they ran away. And Israel won that war. But it was sort of a Brit Milah for the Jewish nation. Now, go into the future 13 years. Israel is 13 years old. Golda Meir is the ambassador to the United Nations. There was something that the UN wanted to condemn Israel for. I don't recall exactly what it was. But they set up a resolution to condemn Israel for something, and which, by the way, they've been doing ever since. Golda Meir got up and said, wait a minute, gentlemen. Do you realize that ever since 1948, when you recognized the state of Israel, you have always declared us to be an underdeveloped state? We're not sitting over there at the Table of Nations with the rest of you. We're sitting over here with a delegation of underdeveloped nations. You don't even recognize us as a nation. Therefore, if you do not recognize Israel as a nation, you have no jurisdiction over us. Well, that was a real head-scratcher. The delegates to the United Nations realized that they didn't have any jurisdiction over Israel if they didn't recognize Israel as a nation to begin with. So, the Soviet ambassador stood up and said, I make a motion that we recognize the state of Israel as a full-fledged nation. And they took the vote and passed. So Golda Meir and her entourage got up, moved from the Table of Underdeveloped Nations over to the have a seating at the Table of Nations. And then, as they began to try to condemn Israel once again, Golda Meir got up and said, wait a minute, now that we are a sovereign nation, this is our bar mitzvah. Israel is 13 years old. We are now declared an adult among the nations of the world, and I want you to know that we declare our sovereignty, and as a sovereign nation, we can do anything we want to do, and you can't tell us one way or the other. And she was right. So they had to drop the resolution. 13th year of Israel. The next thing that happens to a Jewish man is when he's 20 years old, he's inducted into military service. In fact, if you read Numbers chapter 1, you will find that Moses had a census taken so that they could induct all the men 20 years of age and older into the military, have a standing army for Israel. And it's been that way ever since. When a Jewish man is 20, he's inducted into the military service. Well, that means that when Israel was in his 20th year, 1967, Israel had to go to war. And she did. The infamous, or shall we say the famous, Six-Day War. That's when Israel conquered East Jerusalem, took it away from Jordan, conquered the Sinai, and the Golan Heights. And, of course, they've been bargaining chips ever since. Well, that was when Israel was 20. The next stage in a Jewish man's life is when he's 30 years old. He's declared fully mature. It's, for example, Joseph was 30 years old when Pharaoh discussed his dream and as a consequence put Joseph in charge of raising the funds and the grain and what have you for the next 7 years of plenty so that they would have enough when the 7 years of famine came. Joseph was 30. Now, Jesus was 30 when he began his ministry. Ezekiel was 30 when he began writing Ezekiel. David was 30 when he became the king of Israel. So you get the picture. A Jewish priest, a Levite, entered his office. That is, he began his work as a priest at the age of 30, because 30 was the age of full maturity. So, when Israel was 30 years old, Pharaoh came to visit. That was Anwar Sadat. And eventually they struck a deal for a peace accord. And that gives you basically the life of a Jew. Now, I cannot tell you beyond that exactly what happens. I know at the age of 50, they'd have some kind of jubilee. I'm not sure whether that's speaking individually or just as a nation. But the Jewish calendar jubilee was 1994-95. Nevertheless, we have this fascinating study. I want to thank you for your emails, and we'll get to other emails and the questions you have in time to come. It's been a delightful day. It's good to visit with you. We'll see you again tomorrow with our analysis of the news.